The letter announcing the visitation of the superintendent, the district supervisors, and the division supervisors for purposes of inspection and evaluation of the school. After the principal read the letter, he decided to have a meeting with the faculties.
Good morning, teachers.
Good morning, sir.
The visitors will come on Saturday at exactly 1 o'clock in the afternoon. So I decided to divide you into 4 groups. The first group composed of Ms. Divina Gracia.
Yes, sir.
The second group composed of Mr. Benapor.
Yes, sir.
The third group assigned for structuring the room.
Yes, sir.
And the fourth group composed by Rodriguez freshmen under the stewardess of Ms. Noel.
Yes, sir.
So I'm expecting you to be responsible in your part.
Yes, sir.
That's all.
After the meeting.
Good morning, class.
Good morning, ma'am.
So before we start, I have an announcement. We have a visitor, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
So we are assigned for preparing the food for our visitors. So I want you to cooperate, move faster, and do your part. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Morning.
Good morning, sir.
So we are assigned to the buildings and the dishes after the supper later, and make sure that our visitor will be more comfortable in their beds at night.
Do your work properly.
Yes, sir.
During the preparation, Miss Noel and Mrs. Albes met at the lavatory.
Miss Noel, can you help me fix my pocket zipper?
Sure, I can help you.
Thank you.
supper, sir. You must be tired.
Yes, indeed. And I'd like to freshen up. And I hope to see someone to take care of my orchids or my wife will skin me alive.
Sure, sir. I trust nothing matters with Mr. Ampil, sir.
So you haven't heard? The old fool broke a collarbone. He's dead.
Oh.
You see, instead of doing all duties expected of him, he'll be ahead of us in the school we are visiting. If he felt we were dawdling on the road, he'd go by horseback or carabao sled to the distant one where the road is inaccessible by bus at his age. Then in our visitation to Barrio Tungkod, you know that place, don't you?
Yes.
On our way to that forsaken island, that muddy hellhole, he slipped on the bangka. Well, that's it.
How terrible!
Funny thing is, they had to pass the hut around to buy him a coffin. It turned out the below as poor as the church mouse. You'd think why this fool had been 30 years in service, never a day absent, never a day late, never told a lie. You'd think he'd get a decent burial, but he hadn't reached 65 and wasn't going to get a cent he was working for. Well, that's a turn of his side. I think all teachers hated all strict supervisors. Didn't you all quit for your life when Mr. Ampil was there waiting at the door of the first classroom before you ever opened it with your key?
Feared him, yes, but also respected and admired him for what he stood for.
So that's how the wind blows. You must be kind to us poor supervisors. The things we go through at pagkabuhay, what's her name again? The grammar teacher who held the demonstration class under the mango tree. Quite impressive and modern, but the whole class has been so well rehearsed and they are reciting like machine guns. I think it's someone, a code they have. The student knows the answer. He raises left hand, and if doesn't, he raises right hand. Something to that effect. What I mean is, well, what's the use of going through all that palabas? As I always say, let's get to the heart of the matters.
You mean, get to the roots of the problems?
Hell no. I mean the dance. I always believe that there's no school problem that a good round of tango will not solve. Come, girl. I was really joking.
As the bell rang, Miss Noel entered 1B followed by Mr. Sawit.
I live in Barrio! I live in Ikaw! I live in Pugatawin! I live on street! I live on Calle Rian!
Good afternoon, class!
Good afternoon, ma'am!
So we have a visitor, our new English supervisor, Mr. Sawit.
Good afternoon, sir!
after the dinner.
Compañero, this is Miss Noel, our English teacher. She will be greatly honored if you offer a dance with her.
Compañero, I didn't know that Pugad Lali grows such an exquisite flower.
Suggested to drive at next town where the feast was being celebrated. Miss Noel, Mrs. Divina Gracia remained and his staff, pleading a headache, and also Mr. Sawit remained behind.
The principal says that you're quite headstrong, Miss Noel. But then, I don't put much stock by what the principal says.
If you meant why I refused to dance with Mr. Lokban?
No, just things in general. The visitation, for instance. What do you think of it?
Do you want my frank opinion, sir?
Yes, of course.
Well, it's all a farce.
That's what I've heard. What makes you think that?
Isn't it obvious? You announce a whole month ahead that you're visiting. We clean the schoolhouse, dump the trash in the drawers, and bring out our best manners. As you said before, we rehearse our classes. Then we roll out our red carpet, and you believe that you observe us in our everyday surrounding, in our everyday comportment?
Of course you know that.
That's what I mean. We know that you know. And you know that we know that you know.
Come now. Isn't that putting it triple strongly?
No. In fact, I overheard one of your companions a while ago that if our lechon is crispier than that of the preceding school, if our pabaon is more lavish, we would get a high efficiency rating.
Of course he was merely joking. I see what Mr. Olbes meant about you being stubborn.
And what about one supervisor? An acquaintance of yours, I know, who used to come before the town fiesta and assign us the following items. 6 chickens, 2 goats, 150 eggs, 12 leche plants. I know the list by heart. I was assigned the checker.
There are a few measurable exceptions.
What about the sweepstakes agent supervisor, who makes the teacher's clearance for the withdrawal of his pay? How do you explain him? Sir, during the 5 years that I've taught, I've done my best to live up to my ideals, yet I please nobody. It's the same old narrow conformism in favor of grade. What matters is not how well one teaches, but how well one learns the art of pleasing the powers that be. And it's the same all the way up.
So you want to change the world? I've been in the service for a long time, 17 years. This bald spot on my head caused mostly by new teachers who want to set the world on fire. In my younger days, I wouldn't hesitate to recommend you for expulsion for your rash opinions. But I've grown old and mellow. I recognize punk, and I'm willing to give it a credit. But spunk is only hard-headedness, if not direct forward to channels. But you're young enough. You will learn the hard way. Sign here and there, but you will learn.
How are you so sure?
They all do. There are thousands of teachers. They are delusional, but they go on teaching. It's the only place where a woman to go. There will be a reclassification next month. Mr. Olbes is out to get you. He too, on the ground of insubordination, you know that. But I'm willing to stick my neck out for you if you just stop on being such an idealistic fool and henceforth expressing no more personal ideas. Let's live in those lives, Noel. I shall give you a good rating after this visitation because you remind me of my younger sister for no other reason. And after a year, when I find that you learn to curb your tongue, I'm willing to give you a post in Manila where your talents will not be wasted. I'm related to Mr. Alba, you know. You see, education is not so much a matter of brain as getting along with one's fellow men. Else, how could I have risen in my present position? All the fools I started out with are still head teachers in godforsaken barrio. And how can one be idealistic in a mud hole? Good night, my dear.
Give up your teaching, Noel. In a couple of months, you might be the head of our company. We need someone educated because we plan to export.
She remembered Clem coming into the house after the first troubled months of teaching and persuading her to come to Manila because his boss was in need of a secretary. Typing, filing, shorthand, she had spat the words contemptuously back at him. I was given a head so I could think. Pride goes.
Pandemonyo mo her, ma'am.
Dear perceptive Leon, he wanted to become a lawyer. Pugad lawits first. What kind of a peaker was she to betray a dream like that? What would happen to him if she wasn't there to teach him his P's and F's? Leon walked swiftly under the window. In Miss Noel's eyes, he had already won a case. After breakfast the next morning, the supervisors packed their belongings and were soon ready.
This Prince song inside my head. Hands up if you're down to get down tonight, 'cause it's always a good time. Slept in all my clothes like I didn't care. Hopped into a cab, take me anywhere. I'm in if you're down to get down tonight, 'cause it's always a good time.